Good evening. A big step in our return to normal today. Lunchboxes packed and classrooms again brimming with pupils as more than 500,000 Year 2 to 11 students join their classmates back at school. And while there were smiles galore, there was confusion too. Many schools were shut down for cleaning after positive COVID cases.
The Della's kids were ready in record time this morning. Breakfast down the hatch, lunch packed, uniform, shoes, hair, tick, tick, tick.
It was just sort of wake up, very excited, get into the rhythm again and get back to face-to-face learning.
A spring in their step as 11-year-old Chloe walked into the final weeks of primary school. Little brother Ryan, soon to complete year two.
Enjoy, guys.
Bye. Okay, have a great day.
Happy. Happy for them more than me. They need to get back to normality.
More than 500,000 students from years 2 to 11 returned to the classroom today. Campuses back at capacity, officially marking the end of online learning and the beginning of traffic turmoil. Cars crawling along the Cumberland Highway as families hit the road, but no one really seemed to mind on this momentous day. The school hallway buzz at St Patrick's Marist was music to the principal's ears.
Sitting in my office this morning, hearing that wonderful noise, a school without kids is just a building and it's just come to life.
Oh my goodness, it felt amazing just to see my friends, not over FaceTime, over Snapchat anymore, just to see them face to face.
But it will soon be mate against mate with everyone's favourite subject, the school sport, back on the curriculum from November 1.
Just that connection that students can have to be able to be going out, kicking a footy with their mates or playing netball, that's an important part of the school experience.
Also part of the experience, school shutdowns.
It's closed.
A confirmed COVID case closing Mount Druitt Public for deep cleaning. Some families missing the memo.
No, I didn't know, no.
And I can stay at home all day.
This is just one of 16 schools closed today, the longest list we've seen in a while. But the government has warned this is the new normal and the average turnaround is only 24 hours, except for families in isolation.
Danny Jordan's son, Sevi, is a close contact and has been ordered to stay home from kindy for 2 weeks. She and their youngest boy locked up too, while her husband couch surfs with family and friends to keep their business running.
We're supposed to be setting up a new cafe. That's the whole reason that my husband has to stay in a completely different place.
A big burden on the family that feels like a game of Russian roulette.
If this was to happen again straight away when he goes back, I don't know how I'm going to manage to keep it together.
If there was one lesson learnt from lockdown, take it one day at a time. Tiffany Genders, Nine News.
Parents of kindergarten students and preschoolers will be able to pocket $100 vouchers from the Premier to pay for swimming lessons. The First Lap program was today expanded to include kindergarten students who missed out on the government-funded program due to lockdown.
Just in time for summer, helping kids learn how to swim, saving lives and putting downward pressure on family budgets.
The vouchers are available from December 1 through the Service New South Wales app. A summer of sport is all but locked in, but for those tennis players or Sydney to Hobart yachties wanting to compete, vaccination will be their ticket. The Australian Open is right now in talks with government officials as to how they can get the world's top seeds on the court, even if they haven't had a jab.
The vaccination debate in American sport has turned ugly. Protesters go into battle for Australian-born NBA star Kyrie Irving, who's been banned from playing home games with his team, the Nets, because in New York, you have to be jabbed. That hardline approach is set to be extended to the Australian Open. A leaked email to the Women's Tennis Association has stated unvaccinated players will be subject to 2 weeks hard quarantine.
Their professional associations were all strongly recommending that they get vaccinated and that they were likely to do so between now and Christmas.
There is speculation defending champion Novak Djokovic is among those resisting.
You'd have to ask him and he'll get upset if you ask him, so there's probably no getting an answer.
An Australian Open with or without the Joker, it seems we can lock in the famous Sydney to Hobart Yacht Classic after COVID forced its cancellation last year. The clincher, Tasmania's decision to open its borders from December 15. But like the tennis and the basketball, the health rules will apply.
Everybody has to be double vaccinated and have a valid COVID test within 72 hours of departure.
As we look to the future, today the past delivered a grim new milestone from the Delta outbreak, which began in June. Four more deaths, taking the total beyond the 500 mark.
I guess that number is a reminder of the challenge of the times. There is no evidence that the pandemic is passing.
But there are promising signs in the daily case numbers. Another day under 300. Despite earlier predictions, infections would rise sharply as we opened up. Damien Ryan, Nine News.
New South Wales continues to lead all states in vaccination, but tonight there are concerns ahead of our next round of freedoms. Charles Croucher is with me in the studio this evening. Charles, what are the latest figures?
Pete, we are already up to 93.1% first dose, a milestone, 85% second dose. But the success is really shown in those suburbs once considered hotspots. Blacktown is up to 94.8% double dose, Cumberland 86.5%, and Canterbury Bankstown at 85%. This time next week, regional New South Wales will be back open, but look at some of the rates in the popular tourist spots. On the north coast, Byron at 63.5% fully vaccinated, Lismore 69.3%, even Tweed on the border is down at 71.8%. It's a different story away from the coast. Orange all the way at 91.5%, the Snowies 83.9%. So the two extra weeks helped, but a test is coming for the regions, Pete.
Charles, thank you.